Hey, what's going on, guys? I'm going to do a book review for you guys called On the Flight of Jesse Leroy Brown by Theodore Taylor. And it's a really good book. I read the book yesterday. And Jesse Leroy Brown was the very first African-American naval aviator. He died on December 4th, 1950 in the Zhangjin or Chosun Reservoir. And Zhangjin, you can call it Zhangjin or Chosun Reservoir. And how he passed away was the Chinese soldiers would dress in white uniforms, blend in with the snow, and if American planes flew low to the ground, they would shoot down the plane. And one of Jesse Leroy Brown's wingmen, Lieutenant William Koenig, K-O-E-N-I-G, that was his name, from Iowa. Lieutenant Koenig was from Iowa. He wanted to fly the Corsair. That was the planes they flew ever since he was in high school. But anyway, Lieutenant Koenig noticed smoke coming from Jesse Leroy Brown's plane. Jesse Leroy Brown was able to crash land his plane, but his knee was trapped under the fuselage. And Thomas Hudner, one of the other wingmen, he crash landed his plane to try to save Jesse Leroy Brown. They got a rescue helicopter there, but they could not do anything. The plane was burning from underneath. They tried to put snow where the fires were burning. That didn't work. They didn't have the proper knife to amputate or cut off Jesse Leroy Brown's leg. The knee was just trapped under the fuselage for hours, and Jesse Leroy Brown was slipping in and out of consciousness like this. I mean, he was waking up, going back to sleep. It was just a hopeless situation. Thomas Hudner did all he could do, and because of that, he was awarded the Medal of Honor. That's the highest award a soldier can get. Okay, well, back to Jesse Leroy Brown. Okay, Jesse Leroy Brown attended Eureka High School. His principal, growing up, and one of his mentors was a guy by the name of Nathaniel Berger. Actually, in Hattiesburg, Mississippi, Jesse Leroy Brown's hometown, they have a middle school named after Nathaniel Berger. Berger really mentored Jesse Leroy Brown. Jesse Leroy Brown wanted to go to Ohio State. The reason he wanted to go to Ohio State was for a number of reasons, but one is because Ohio State was an integrated university. Blacks and whites went to the same school there. Largely, Mississippi at the time was segregated. African Americans went to one school, whites went to another school, okay? Okay. But Jesse Leroy Brown did not think he was inferior to white people. He wanted to compete at the same level with white people. So that's why he wanted to go to Ohio State. Also, he was a track star in Eureka High School. He ran a lot. And his hero, Olympic hero, Jesse Owens, went to Ohio State. Jesse Owens won the 100 and 200 meter dashes in the 1936 Olympics in Berlin, Germany. Okay, talked about that. Jesse Leroy Brown also wanted to be a naval aviator, and he did not let the color barrier affect him. Okay, his older brother Marvin gave him money to go see a movie, Hell's Angels, and that was about U.S. Air Force pilots fighting against the German Air Force in World War I. And Jesse Leroy Brown could always envision himself shooting down German airplanes. And he also knew about the Tuskegee Airmen, but he wanted to also take off and land from carriers. Because back then, you really had to rely on yourself as well as the LSO, the landing signal officer, the guy on the carrier who gave you the landing signals to land on that carrier. There's not all this high-tech computer technology like there is now. So to be a naval aviator, it really took a lot of extra work taking and landing off from that carrier. So you really were a star aviator if you became a naval aviator during that time of World War II in Korea. And Jesse Leroy Brown wanted to do that. And he wanted just a shot. He wanted an equal shot. He said he didn't want any special treatment, but he didn't want any worse treatment. And by and large, in the U.S. Navy, that's what he got, particularly during pilot training. Prime example. When basic pilot training, he had an instructor that requested to train him. It was a guy by the name of Lieutenant Junior Grade Roland Christensen. Everybody called him Chris. Chris really took Jesse Leroy Brown under his wing, made sure Jesse Leroy Brown passed, really had a lot of patience with Jesse. And Jesse Leroy Brown, even though he had to go to another base and Roland Christensen at another base, even though the Navy separated them, they remained in touch with letters. Junior Grade Roland Christensen was a Caucasian white person from Nebraska. He was a farm boy from Nebraska. And Jesse Leroy Brown's parents were sharecroppers from Mississippi. Okay, sharecropper is a very poor farmer. But Jesse Leroy Brown's parents said, don't think you're poor. You have your pride and you have your dignity. Jesse Leroy Brown's parents also had the children in church. Jesse Leroy Brown loved to sing. He loved to sway. He loved to be in the church. His father was a deacon in the church. His mother taught Sunday school. So Jesse Leroy Brown, as well as his wife Daisy, They were not anti-white or anti-Caucasian in the least. He really appreciated what Roland Christensen did for him. Also, Lieutenant Zastry, after he graduated basic pilot training, Jesse Leroy Brown had an instructor named Lieutenant Zastry. Lieutenant Zastry was very hard on Jesse, but Lieutenant Zastry did not fail Jesse. He was determined to see Jesse through Jesse earned passing. But he graded Jesse hard, but anytime Lieutenant Zastry had to appear before a board or anything, Lieutenant Zastry always defended Jesse Leroy Brown. Also, Jack Keefe was friends with Jesse Leroy Brown. Now, Lieutenant Tipton was not. Lieutenant Tipton left a note on Jesse Leroy Brown's bunk and said, N-word, go home. I don't use that word. I'm not going to, but you guys know what that letter said. I mean, it was a sick note, sadistic note. But Jesse Leroy Brown did not let that get in the way of his perseverance to becoming a naval aviator. And by the time he became a naval aviator in 1948, a lot of the African-American enlisted sailors were really impressed with what Jesse Leroy Brown had accomplished, and they really took a liking to Jesse Leroy Brown. And Jesse Leroy Brown, when the Korean War came around, Jesse Leroy Brown served in Squadron 92, Task Force 77, aboard the USS Leyte. He flew the F-4 Corsair, and he was shot down in Seomong-ni in the Jiangjin Reservoir. And he believed in what his country was doing against the communists. He believed in fighting in the Korean War. Everything, his personal letters to his wife Daisy, which they corresponded regularly, and they were a very loving and in love couple. His last words when he died was, "Tell Daisy I love her." That was his exact last words before he died. It was, "Tell Daisy I love her." And his best friend in the Navy was a guy by the name of Leland Nelson and his wife, Lee LaCroix Nelson. They were a very in love couple as well, and Jesse would always write to Daisy about how in love they were. Daisy was impressed with it too, even though Jesse and Daisy were a very in love couple. Also, Lieutenant William Koenig, K-O-E-N-I-G, I showed you pictures in the previous video of him. He was from Iowa. He was very impressed with Jesse's accomplishments. Also, those guys they called Chef. His name was Sheffield. He's from Texas. Sheffield was very protective of Jesse Leroy Brown and really was upset or offended if any sailors made any derogatory remarks towards Jesse Leroy Brown. So Squadron 92 regularly and definitely accepted Jesse Leroy Brown, and they were impressed with all his accomplishments. Also, when Jesse Leroy Brown became a naval aviator, he took some leave to go visit families in Mississippi and his mother-in-law became sick, so he was speeding in his car just to get to the hospital. Cop pulled him over. He asked for ID. When Jesse Leroy Brown showed him his ID, it showed that he was a naval aviator. The cop let him go. Nothing happened. I don't justify what a lot of cops did in the Deep South at the time. It was sick and despicable. I'm just doing this to remind people of Jesse Leroy Brown's accomplishments and legacy. And he was an impressive individual, and I'm proud that he's from Hattiesburg, Mississippi. I have ties to Hattiesburg, Mississippi, and he was definitely an excellent soldier, excellent person, excellent Christian, devoted husband. I hate that his legacy is largely unknown. It's one reason I'm doing this video, because we need to honor Jesse Leroy Brown's legacy. I spent 2 years in Korea as an English teacher, and he is a major reason that Korea is free. He fought bravely in the battles of Jiangjin Chosun Reservoir. And God bless Jesse Leroy Brown. I'm going to do further videos reading some quotes from the book, but God bless Jesse Leroy Brown. Hope everybody's doing well. Take care. God bless. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.